So we're doing your carpal tunnel. Some patients prefer to be sedated and not to be aware of anything with the procedure. And in that case, we can absolutely do the procedure in the OR. Other patients feel very comfortable. We do the procedure in the office. We simply numb up the area. Same exact procedure we would do in the OR, except it's a little bit less hassle for the patient. They can come in a little bit later. They don't have to wait around as long. It's also safer in the sense that they don't require any sedation medications, which can have side effects. So I'm getting the numbing medication ready here. This is not the needle we're going to use for you. We're going to use a little itty-bitty skinny needle. So don't be worried. So this is lidocaine with epinephrine. This is like what the dentists use to numb things up. And it makes you really nice and numb, but it also controls the bleeding, which is what we need to do, and allows us to do the procedure here in the office as opposed to into the operating room. In the operating room, we often use a tourniquet, which is like a blood pressure cuff on your arm. Uh-huh. And that can be painful, and so a lot of people need some sedation or sleepy medication in order to tolerate that blood pressure cuff. So we skip the pain part. A little cleaning solution kills the germs that live on the skin. All right. This is a little stick. Uh-huh. All right. Little stick. 1, 2, 3. All right. Getting real numb. Uh-huh. All right. That's all there is to it.
Good.
That's all there is to it. That's the worst part of today. So we'll let that numbing medication set up.
Okay.
And then we'll wash up your hand, and then we'll do the procedure. I think there's many advantages to doing the procedure here in the office. One of them is the cost. The cost of doing the procedure in office is much less than the operating room with a large operating room staff, the anesthesia fees, the additional fees for testing, such as getting a preoperative examination, additional fees for equipment like placing an IV and the IV medications, which we don't use here in the office. Another advantage is the time savings for the patient. Not only is the procedure a bit quicker in terms of not having to wait around as much to do the procedure, in addition, patients don't have to go visit with their primary care provider to get preoperative clearance. And many patients who are older and very medically infirm can have the procedure done in the office because we're not giving those sedation medications. All right, and what are we doing for you today?
You're doing a surgery on the hand. To combat the numbness of the fingers.
You got it, carpal tunnel release surgery. All right, everybody agree?
Yeah.
We'll go ahead and get started here. You let me know if anything's uncomfortable or unpleasant.
Is it okay if I watch?
It's absolutely okay if you watch. Just don't lean over into the wound, okay? Did you eat breakfast today?
Right,
Yeah, did you have to take any, did you skip any of your medications or you were able to take them all?
No, I took them all.
Yeah.
I had my bowl of oatmeal.
Good. Well, the nice thing about doing it here in the office this way is that you don't have to skip a meal, don't have to go into the OR, you don't have to have the medications that can make you sleepy and interfere with higher mathematical skills. And I'm going to move your nerve out of the way. Go ahead and wiggle your fingers like you're making a fist. See those things moving in the bottom of their wound?
What's that white thing?
That's a tendon right here.
Is that, and does the nerve go through the tendon?
No, the nerve sits next to the tendon. The nerve's right here.
Uh-huh.
And we're just moving it out of the way, and there's your tendon right there. You see it moving back and forth?
Okay. Yeah. But now, does the tendon pinch the nerve?
No, they all sit under that ligament that we cut.
Oh.
Which is right here. Uh-huh. See that right there? And also right there.
So how do you get the nerve so it's not being pinched anymore?
We cut that ligament that's sitting on top of the nerve.
Uh-huh.
The ligament springs apart and it leaves more space available for the nerve.
Hmm.
Yeah, the ligament eventually heals or reconstitutes.
Will it ever grow back so I'd have to have it done over again?
Unlikely. Sometimes it does grow back, but it usually takes a long time.
Oh. Maybe that's one of the advantages of being 84 years age.
The recovery after the carpal tunnel surgery is the same whether it's done in the OR or in the clinic. The advantage is that you leave the clinic here with a little carpal tunnel dressing that you take off in 1 or 2 days. Patients in general usually say once they've done the carpal tunnel release, I don't know why I waited so long. Many of them have had symptoms that keep them from sleeping well at night for months to years. And in most cases, they're extremely pleased with the results of the operation and their level of pain relief.
And I know, and I may would have had it done a year earlier.
All right, that's all there is. We'll put a little dressing on it, and away we go.
Well, thank you, Doctor.
You're welcome. My pleasure.